Are you feeling overwhelmed by the pressure to achieve your goals before the end of the year? If so, you are not alone. Many people feel stressed and anxious during this time of the year as they try to cram everything into a short period of time. Relax and watch this video to the end to learn how to avoid end-of-year pressure and achieve your goals in a stress-free way. Hi friends, if this is your first time here, my entire YouTube channel is dedicated to help you reinvent yourself and start a new and purpose-driven life. I make these videos to share my own transformation journey and to remind you that you are not a failure just because you failed at something at some point. We are all a work in progress, and yes, there is always room for improvement. Resilience is about using lessons from our challenges to build back better. We are literally in November, which means 2 months to 2025. Yes, the end of 2024. And this is that time of the year where many people do their evaluation. It's the time of the year where many people answer those burning questions. What have I achieved this year? How has my life changed? What impact did I make? Who did I help? How did I serve myself, my family, my community? So whatever your answers to these questions, do not let the feelings of anxiety and stress overwhelm you. I always concentrate on how far I have come when taking stock or when evaluating my journey. I focus on seeing the glass as half full. For me, it is, yes, I am not yet where I want to be, but I am no longer where I was this time last year. So I always count my blessings. And please, when you count your blessings and your achievements, you will be amazed at how long your list can be. So this video shares 4 ways in which you can achieve your goals in a healthy, sustainable way. The first thing is realistic goal setting. Yes, at the beginning of 2024, you set some goals for yourself. Sometimes we are very ambitious, which can lead to disappointment and increased stress. The good news is that we can always break down our large goals into smaller, manageable, actionable steps. Prioritize and focus on what truly matters. So instead of aiming to complete a massive project, divide it into smaller, manageable tasks. One of my objectives in 2024 was to publish my book, The Power of Reset. In the course of the year, I realized that it was taking me more time to put together the money to publish the whole book. What did I do? I stayed in action, but I pivoted. This time, I focused on what my current budget could achieve and carved out one chapter of the book and self-published it as a workbook to help you with your auto-evaluation and self-awareness. I had to break down my goal, and voila, you have the workbook published. I self-published it, and it is in Amazon, and the link is in this video description. Instead of lamenting and waiting until I had all the money to publish all the book, I break it down. I focused on what to me was more important, self-awareness, and I carved out a workbook. You can do the same with your own goals, even if you did not achieve the bigger project or all the project. The best is always yet to come. Number 2, effective time management. Effective time management is the ability to organize and manage time effectively, prioritizing tasks and allocating specific time slots to maximize productivity and minimize stress. Remember, we are all about how to minimize stress. We cannot really completely remove stress, but we can minimize it. Sometimes poor time management can lead to feeling overwhelmed and unproductive. So how do we solve this? By prioritizing tasks and allocating specific time slots for work and relaxation. Remember, all work and no play. So you are not only about work, but you have time for work and time for play. And then you monitor your productivity and identify time-wasting habits. So one of the ways is regular self-assessment. So take time from time to time to reflect on your daily activities and identify recurring time-wasting habits. So you can ask yourself questions like, are there specific tasks or projects that consistently take longer than expected? You can also ask yourself, did I find myself frequently checking social media or emails during working hours? I do that too. So all of these are distractions that hinder us to focus and that hinder productivity. We can really try to limit them. We cannot really completely remove them, but we can limit them. So by regularly assessing these habits, you can gain valuable insights into your productivity patterns and take steps to eliminate or to mitigate time-wasting behaviors. The third thing I want to share with you today, stress management techniques. Stress management techniques are strategies and practices designed to help manage stress effectively, reducing its negative impact and promoting our overall well-being. What we are looking for is how to promote our well-being. And there are many ways to enhance our wellness through stress management. Like many people use mindful meditation, which is a practice that involves focusing your attention on the present moment without judgment. So you are present. And this helps you to reduce stress, anxiety, and depression. It improves your focus and your concentration, thereby enhancing emotional regulation. So find a quiet place to sit or lie down, close your eyes, and focus on your breath. Just notice the sensation of the breath as it enters and leaves your body. When your mind wanders, bring it back gently and breathe. Start with short meditation sessions. You can just take 5 minutes, then later you can go to 10 minutes. Some people can take a whole hour. I take 10 minutes. I'm trying to break it to 15, 20 minutes. But if you can take 30 minutes, that's fine. Just do what works for you. Physical exercise is another common way to manage your stress, which entails any form of physical activity that gets your body moving. It reduces your stress hormones, boosts your mood, enhancing endorphins, and improves your sleep and increases your energy levels. So how do we incorporate this? You just find the activities you enjoy, such as walking, dancing, cleaning your house, gardening, swimming, anything that works for you. Some people do yoga, anything that works for you. Some people even find like they're exercising during cooking and all of that. Anything that works for you is fine. The important thing is to shake your body. Like experts also recommend that sitting on your chair for long hours is as bad as smoking. They recommend that you have to get up every 2 hours, walk around, stretch and all of that. So the intent here is to get your body moving. And you have to be intentional. You have to create a personalized relaxation routine and schedule it into your day. So if you cannot do it daily walks, or if you cannot do daily exercises, do it as many days of the week as your time permits. But you have to break up your exercises into shorter, more frequent sessions if needed. All of this according to your schedules. Don't be overwhelmed. Do what you can at the moment. Remember, we want to be at the present moment. So by incorporating these techniques into your daily routine, you can significantly improve your overall well-being, resilience, and stress. And the fourth way, learn to say no. Avoid overcommitting yourself. Learn to say no without feeling guilty or feeling an obligation to explain yourself. Overcommitting yourself can lead to stress, burnout, and a decline in your overall well-being. Learning to say no is a powerful skill that allows you to prioritize your commitments and protect your mental health. So you can do this through honest and direct communication. Be clear and concise. Clearly state that you are not able to take on additional commitments. If possible, you can suggest alternative solutions, offer assistance in other ways, but you have to protect yourself first. If you want to practice empathy, which is a good thing, acknowledge the other person's request and express understanding while still maintaining your boundaries. Somebody with empathy, you feel for the person, but you are looking at yourself. So another way to avoid overcommitting is by setting realistic expectations. Assess your capacity, evaluate your current workload and commitments before agreeing to new tasks. Identify the most important tasks and focus your energy on them. Share responsibilities with others when necessary. So by mastering the art of saying no, you can reduce stress, you can improve your focus, and you can enhance your overall holistic aspects of life. Try to implement these strategies and navigate the year-end stress with greater ease. Remember, self-care is not selfish, and it is essential for long-term well-being and success. Your actions are someone's inspiration, and your willingness to try becomes your inspiration to continue growing. You are just one decision away to a stress-free and successful life. I am your friend for your new journey to the best part of your life. I do not have a magic solution, but I am your guide into self-discovery to help you unlock inbuilt answers and take empowered action to become your best version. You can send me a direct message on Instagram if you want to chat with me. Thank you for watching. Take care of yourself and stay stress-free. I will see you in the next video.